Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today's video we're diving into Loom, which is a video messaging tool that has been around for a long time. I think it was launched back in 2015. It's had 73 million in funding so far and is valued at 350 million. And it's quite a popular tool. So I have been using it, as I said, for about 3 years. But what it does is it's quite smart in the sense that if you don't have a full-blown meeting, but you don't want to necessarily miss out on some of the visual cues when sending stuff in applications like Slack or Twist, and you want to be able to send maybe a screen recording or something that is in front of you, but you can't quite, you know, get the balance between those two, then this allows you to record your screen. And what it does is it quickly uploads that and allows you to share a link, which one allows you to have a better experience in terms of not starting a full meeting, and also allows you to share that quickly versus actually having to upload it, edit it, and send it back out. So this is quite a smart tool. It's being used for a range of different things, feedback, explainers, and things like that. And as I said, they haven't really focused on Teams, but they're really changing this in what's called the all new Loom. So I want to go through some of the changes that they've made, some of the more recent stuff that they've launched. So the first thing is a brand new logo called the Loom Beam logo. And this logo, obviously, not much of a change to the feature set, but really does make things look a lot cleaner. It makes things look a lot cleaner, and they definitely made the sort of brand polished off a lot more than it was. The second major update is about the team workspaces. So back in, I think what they said was May, I thought it was March, they released something called Teams Beta, allowing you to have this sort of workspace for teams to collaborate, whether that's like leaving videos for team members or uploading files, almost like just a team plan basically. But they've really formalized this into what's called a shared workspace or team workspaces, and that allows you to have a range of different things: a team library to centralize your depository of videos, unlimited viewers, so if you want to invite viewers to join your workspace, then you can. They've changed the pricing, I'll explain that in a minute, and also naturally centralized billing and user management administration stuff. The third thing, as I said, is the pricing. The price has changed quite a lot. You've got the starter plan, which is still free, which is a good plan. You get 25 creators on it, and that will probably be good for getting you started. 100 videos and recordings, which is good. And also, I believe it's 5-minute limit on those plans. There are alternatives like Cloud App, which do have some limitations as well, but not as many as Loom. Loom always had a better free plan, and it seems to be, since last time I checked at least, that Loom starter plan is still better than the Cloud App plan. They've launched this thing called Loom Pro in Business. It's basically a plan that makes it more affordable. The plan includes 100 creators, unlimited videos and screen recordings, and unlimited length, as well as plus some additional things like video drawing, calls to actions, custom branding, and engagement insights. So it's quite interesting. You do get a 14-day free trial with that one, but they've also released a new feature called Screenshots, which seems pretty cool. So apparently in the desktop versions on Mac and Windows, they also have an iOS application, by the way, but you can now take a screenshot and it works more like the Cloud App used to work. And I really prefer the Cloud App experience for screenshots, but you can take a screenshot on your desktop device and it'll automatically create a Loom URL. And naturally you can forward that on to the right people in your team. So the final thing is they said the education plan is still free, so you can still get access to that if you are in education, and particularly for some students that are working on projects at home or are teaching classes and they want to do like micro lessons or micro things they're learning across the day, want to share it through Microsoft Teams, this could be quite a good solution. So folks, that's the brand new Loom for Teams. I really guess that's what it's called, but it's all new Loom. It's a really good tool. I actually quite enjoy using it. Here's like my own personal library. If you want to learn how it works, it's quite simple. All you have to do is download the Chrome extension. You can naturally have it directly on your desktop. I should probably get it on my desktop if I'm sending videos. I don't send too many videos, but the way that I sort of use it is if I wanted to send a short recording of myself talking over how to use a tool like I've done in the past here, like for example, like Bear Alpha, some messages to people, then naturally it's a good way to do it quite quickly instead of me having to record a video through this. If I click record a video, this pops up here. So naturally, you can see that, naturally you can see here that I can choose my screen or screen only or just camera only, and I can record the current tab if I want to, but I can record the full desktop, which is good, even if you're using it through the Chrome application. I can change the microphone I'm using, so if you've got a headpiece microphone, you can use that, and I can also change the video that I'm using as well, and naturally hit record. As you can see, they've changed it slightly. So obviously they've notified you of the free, the limit that you've got, and you can upgrade here if you want to. You can have a recording countdown. So that makes it easier for the free plan to understand how the limitations are for their account. Folks, that's how the new Loom works. It is very similar to the previous Loom, but some modifications, some changes, and it's good to see this company move in a direction that looks much more interesting. It's going to be much more popular for teams to use this as a messaging tool to create guides and repositories, so that's a good upgrade for sure. I think it's a nice complementary upgrade to applications like Notion, because you can embed Looms inside of Notion, and it definitely makes your wiki much more attractive for onboarders and also those folks who are already in your team looking to learn something much more interactive. So folks, hopefully you enjoyed today's video. I will be back very soon. Please do subscribe, and I'll talk to you all very soon. Cheerio.